Hi, everyone. This video will show you how to use the Anycubic Photon workshop. I'll walk you through the process of using, setting, adding support, and teach some useful tips. And a part of how to add support to get a more perfect model will be shown in the next video. So let's start. First, you need to select your machine type here to ensure that you can get the correct slice file. Okay, there is a toolbar on the left. The first icon means move. You can adjust the XYZ value or hold the left mouse button to move the model. And if you want to observe the model from different angles, you need to hold the right mouse button and drag it. Just like this. Well, this is the rotation. You can change the value, or select a different color circle line to manually adjust. And there is also a more accurate method of rotation. You can click to select the value, and then scroll the mouse, which will make it easier for you to find the appropriate placement angle. Okay, next, scale, and here is a fit maximum button. Click on it, and the software will automatically help you scale to the maximum size suitable for printing. And sometimes you may need to print multiple models at the same time. You can lay out the models here, and hold Ctrl and A at the same time, select all models. And then you can arrange the layout according to the X or Y axis. Then on the right is the setting of the printing parameters. For most models, you can directly choose to use the default parameters, but we will also introduce you to the role of each parameter so that you can set the best parameters according to your own model. Okay, the first is a calculator, a reference that helps you calculate how much it will cost to print this model. Alright, let's get to the more important part. First, you'll have to select the desired layer height. We recommend going for 0.05 millimeters for most prints. And here is a slice file, and on the left you can see the printed pattern of each layer, and then solidify the resin through layer by layer exposure to form a complete model. So you can choose 0.05 millimeters or lower layer height according to your needs. Of course, if you need higher precision, you can try a lower layer height, and the lower the layer height, the higher the print quality and the longer it takes to complete a single print. Okay, then the normal exposure time is the amount of time that each layer is exposed to the printer's UV light during the printing process. And if you lower the layer height, you also need to shorten the exposure time appropriately. Take monochrome LCD printers as examples, there is a recommended parameter. And if the setting was set too high, the printed model will become wider than expected and a lot of details will be lost. On the other hand, if the exposure time is too short, the model will become narrower or even unable to form. And another two points to be mentioned is that the type of resin and printing temperature will also affect the exposure time. Different manufacturers' resins may have different requirements for exposure time. So try to follow the manufacturer guidelines, but be prepared to make necessary adjustments if needed. And if the room temperature is low, the exposure time can be increased appropriately. Okay, let's check the off time. It means after an exposure, the UV light turns off and the build plate lifts, peels, and rests at the set layer height at the bottom of your dot before the light comes on again for the next exposure cycle. We also recommend you to use the default parameters, about 1 second 3 second, and the longer your off time, the longer your resin has to settle and make room for the next layer. So, if you need to print tooth models and accessories with accurate size, you can add the off time appropriately. And when you are printing a large model, you can also increase the off time to allow the excess resin to stably flow back into the tank, which can increase the chance of successful printing. And for more viscous resin or in a colder environment, you can also add the off time. Then, bottom exposure time. It's similar to exposure time, but only applying to the first few layers or bottom layers of your 3D prints. Sometimes the bottom of the model is not well stuck to the platform or the model is too difficult to remove. You can try to adjust the value here. And our recommended value is the default 40 seconds. The longer your bottom exposure time, the better grip this first layer has on the build platform. So if it is a smaller model, you can try to start from 30 seconds. If the model does not stick to the platform well, you can try to add 10 seconds. On the contrary, if the stick is too strong, you can reduce it. Note: sometimes the model does not stick to the platform because it is not leveled properly, so please check it. Okay, let's check the bottom layer. These layers ensure strong adhesion to the build plate and help in building a successful 3D model. And we recommend you build 4 to 10 bottom layers. And sometimes increasing your bottom layer count is a way of improving your print adhesion when your models are not sticking to the printing platform properly. but please do not add too much. Too much bottom layers will increase the tensile force of FEP film. Well, the following three parameters generally do not need to be modified. We recommend using the default values. The lift distance means the height to which the build platform will rise. And the optimal value would be somewhere between 6 and 8 millimeters. If the value is too small, the model is highly likely to not come off the bottom of the VAD at all. So if you are printing a larger and heavier model, you can try to reduce the speed or just use the default value. The Z-retreat speed is also the same, generally do not modify, just use the default value. And about anti-alias, aliasing is the staircase effect that occurs when diagonal or curved lines or borders are drawn on raster displays consisting of square or rectangular pixels. Anti-aliasing is to smooth object edges by reducing the number of lines and vertical artifacts you see on your 3D printed model. Photon Workshop provides anti-aliasing function with 1, 2, 4, 8 level. So if you want a smoother surface, you can try to increase the level of anti-aliasing. Okay, this is the first part, we will talk about these in the next video, and if you still have any doubts or have any suggestions about the video, you can comment below. Thanks for watching.